these sessions, so make sure you pay attention in a moment when I go to Google Classroom and explain everything. As far as that being introduction, that's all I have. I'm going to start recording. If you wish, but I'm going to be sharing my screen. I'm not going to see you either way. I'm not going to be on the screen. So that is, are we, I don't want to mark somebody as absent that's actually here, but we see yourself, Diego, Lucio, Juan, Alexis, Andrew, Jason, Corey, Bogart. I'm sorry, who was it?
Well, I have to leave because I'm here, so I have to come back.
Diego said that? That's what I said. Okay. Anybody else? Let's get moving on. All right, so if we go over to Google Classroom, period 6. You are going to see two things listed. The one that says character letter TDQ, that is going to be for the second part of today's session. You have no idea what that is, which is fine. If you pay attention to what I'm saying, you pay attention to today's session, it'll all make sense in real time. This class will go fast. Let's take a look at the main assignment for today. I want to take a creative approach, and you're going to see it's not just going to be for the Crucible. When we read of Mice and Men, when we read The Great Gatsby, anytime we read any major literature, we're going to, at some point, do this type of assignment. And let me explain what that is. It's something I've been doing for years, and I've gotten great responses from students over the years. Again, not just for the Crucible, I'm sorry, I'm talking about for anything that we're reading. But let me walk you through what the assignment is, and you're going to have about 15 or so minutes to work on it, and then we're going to come back together as a class, and I'll explain what part two is. What I need you to pay attention to is that second grade that I said for today's session, which is listed as character letter TDQ, I need everybody to understand that at the end of today's session, it may get pushed to Tuesday depending how fast we go through. I'm going to go through the entire roster. I don't do this often, but do it every so often. I think it's a good practice. It's good for participation, especially virtually. You need to get more voices. And I'm going to call on each person. The way you get credit is, trust me, even if you're shy, you don't have your camera, this is nothing to be worried about. You are going to just have to put a voice from something that you got out of today's session. And I'll explain that when we get to that. So just make sure, the reason I'm saying this, make sure you're paying attention, because at some point, there's a simple grade out there for you. If I call on you, but if you don't answer, you'll get that grade. So pay attention to today's session. All right, you're going to be writing a letter to a character you are choosing in the Crucible. We've now read Act 2. We have a lot more information. If you recall, as I said, is that this is how we do this, right? We read Act 1, pretty fast, and then we stop, we take a quiz, we talk about it, we do activities. Did the same thing with Act 2. We just took a quiz on it. Now we're going to do a quick classwork activity so that... see if you can enter the scene, enter the play. And what do I mean by that? Follow step by step. I'm going to go through this. As I said, step one, you're choosing character. Step two, you're going to list 5 to 7 words that come to mind. This is going to get that thought going with this assignment. Refer to prior assignments, discussions, and that group work activity assignment that we had worked on a couple weeks ago. Remember from Act 1, we met up in groups and we each had a character and we were listing words of what came to mind. Whether we trust this character. We had a lot of thoughts. Then step three. You're going to write a letter to this character. You're writing a letter to this character. So, follow along what I have here that will get you started. Focus on tone in the letter. So that is what I'm trying to say, is to make sure you deliver your message to this character. So if you're writing to Abigail and you're like really ticked off with her and what she's doing in this play, make that seem like, use the word choice, obviously school appropriate, but use word choice that is a very stern. Use punctuation such as exclamations. Get your point across. There are some questions here that may get you going if you're struggling. Say you pick a character, start asking yourself, are you frustrated with this character? Do you think this character is being fairly treated or unfairly treated? If you were to enter the scene, what would you say to this character? So let's say all of a sudden, poof, you're dropped in, and you see Abigail, you see John Proctor, you see Elizabeth, you list all the characters. Who are you going to turn to, and what are you going to say? Maybe it's a happy letter to somebody. Maybe you're very happy with the way somebody's handled the situation. Maybe you're very angry at the way somebody's manipulating other people. You can go on and on and ask this question. The assignment, if you take a look at the italicized wording here at the bottom, is that this assignment should be completed in at least 125 words. Once you start to get your thought out there, 125 words is not that much. Okay? It can't be 2 sentences. You can't be like, dear Elizabeth, I feel sorry for you. I can't believe this is happening. Wow, you got arrested. This is crazy. Like, that's a start, but that's not a letter. Right? That's just a quick thought. So make sure 125 words, get your point across. Show me, remember, me as a teacher, what do I need to see? I need to see that you understand analytically, right? Not just being able to tell me where the setting is. I need to know analytically that you're able to understand where the characters are, their role, what they're doing to the plot, and how you can enter and express how you feel to inform these characters. So 125 words. The second part is, I'll explain later, that the second part of class is where you're going to be taking your response. You're going to either copy and paste your entire letter or a portion of your letter, what you think would be the best part of it. You're going to copy that into a TDQ on Google Classroom, which I already have set up, which we'll do later. And the whole class is going to see your part that you copy and paste. And then we're going to have a discussion. That's with participation grade at the end, which I'll explain. For now, one step at a time. I'm not trying to confuse you because I'm doing 2 things at once to catch up for Wednesday's session. It is 9:35. I'm giving you until, let's see, I'll do 9:52. I think the other class I did right around, I promise I'm talking like 15-16 minutes. 9:52, you need to have this assignment completed so that we can move on to the second part of class, which is more of a together session. This is the independent part. So you can do your letter right on here. You have Oh, so that's not part of the letter? Like the 5-7 word stuff? Or is it?